In a way, you could say that atheists and Christians are not dissimilar from the Christian viewpoint, and that they're not living biblically enough. You see, you find out that I'm poor, you call me lazy, but there's like 120 verses in the Bible that basically run down to, if you're a greedy motherfucker and worship money, you are not doing what it takes to be a good Christian. And of course, the atheists will look at that like, yeah, we're kind of the same. I mean, you're right there supporting Bernie Sanders, being a bunch of classists. I mean, just the verse alone about you can't worship God and money. The fact that it's easier for a rich man to go to hell than for a camel to fit through the eye of a needle. And there's like 120 verses where it's like due diligence, don't worship money, you know. But like most of the country is ran by Christians. So, like, if atheists and Christians are the same in that they're classists, and the Democrats at least are going to be on the side of Bernie Sanders. You're hypocrites. Now, here's another thing that might throw you for a loop, agephobes. I'm 40 years old and decided 8 years ago that I wasn't going to date anyone over 24 or under 18. Okay? 18 to 24 would be a good age range for me to date just because they're fertile and I like them. Usually when I have a conversation with them and they're nice to me, I can be nice in return. My rule is no different from what your Bible says. If you're rude to me and you are mean to me, I'm gonna bail on you. I don't have time for your bullshit. You know what I mean? Like, usually atheists are nicer to me than Christians. But I already talked about that in another video. Let's talk about the age phobia. The 18 to 24 thing is because they're more fertile. Also, look at them. They're hot. There's a lot of them that are hot. That doesn't mean that I wouldn't get married. You know what I mean? Like, if you're a Christian, I'll accept you. If you're an atheist, I'll accept you. Which, it says in John 13, 34 through 35, to love everyone, despite the fact that it says in Luke 11, 27, that anybody that doesn't worship me, Jesus Christ, ought to be put to death at my feet. Ignoring the fact that the Bible is the most contradictory piece of shit out there is actually kind of a lie, because the Quran and every holy text that you're going to present to me, it could be the Bhagavad Gita, Adagata Devita, or any rock lyric, or any band, Nirvana, or fucking Foghat, or Bush, or the Foo Fighters. I'm sure, like, within the back catalogs of every band, even Tool, contradictory things are said by the same band. So contradictoriness, I wouldn't say is human nature, because we're just animals. We're the only animal that seems to be, through capitalism, destroying the planet, while all the other animals are sustaining the ecosystem. I'm not trying to get off on a tangent here, but the age phobia, when you say things like I'm a pedophile because I like younger women that are 20 years younger than me, the fact that you cock block me, you little motherfucking ageist bigots, whenever a chick is interested in me, the fact that you run your mouths and call me a creep and then get all upset when I'm like, what the fuck are you little faggot? Hypocrite much, huh? Mark 23 talks all about hypocrites. Read it and weep, sucka. I could just say fool too, but I really want you to be hurt by how hurt I am by you calling me a creep or a creeper. You sound like Satan, and you let your mouth run like you are a Christian, but you sound like Satan. You're like, oh, you know, I'm a Christian, but I'm a talk shit. When Mark 23 clearly shows that you're a hypocrite. The whole chapter is that. And Jesus hated hypocrites. An atheist will look at that and say, yeah, we're kind of the same. We suck too. What do you want? Well, I want a girlfriend. I want to go out on dates. And I want to experience the same life that you guys do. But watch this video again where I'm pointing out your classism, which is against the Bible and Bernie Sanders, your agephobia, which I'm going to get to in a minute, your ageism. With women like me, I could talk to any age group, but I've already dated older women and women my own age, so I want to date younger women just to try something new. Yeah, I'm sure you understand that. But when you say things like, you're 40, they're 21 or 18, it's not age appropriate, I would have the same response if I were Martin Luther King. When there's plenty of pictures of Martin Luther King flipping racists off while he was in the Birmingham jail. I'm not saying that I'm like Martin Luther King. But let's see what the Bible says about agephobia. You're 21, you're a chick, I'm 40, I'm a guy, I'm interested. You call me a schizo, you little... God, I hate you. It's like you're a lesbian or something. You're just like, ugh. Like a closet lesbian. You're calling everybody bitches and you know, I don't know. Lesbians are fine. I have plenty of lesbian friends. The fact is that you're kind of in the closet. You're kind of like overcompensating. Just like overcompensating Republican males do with their little like kill the faggots tattoos from Leviticus that is their own homosexuality that they're hiding with that stupid tattoo, despite the fact that the same book on the next page says if you get tattoos, you're a sinner and going to hell. And eating shellfish and wearing fabrics of two different kinds of cloth, like polycotton socks. But you never notice that you're a hypocrite, which is rather enlightening to me as an anti-theist, because I look at that like you guys are just either ignorant or willfully ignorant. So when you're running your mouths talking shit, there's plenty of virus out there in the form of meme where gossip is wrong. You can look in the Bible. You know, a meme is basically spreads like a virus. There's so many fucking quotes in the Bible about how gossip is wrong, but you're doing it anyway, talking shit, cock blocking, and you're not accepting the problem is you in the way of me even meeting interested chicks. Because whenever I'm downtown next to the bar or in a bar, they become interested, and then you come up and kiss them, cock block, you're a little bitch, and you're running your mouth. Your rumor shit Bible says, you know, no. So I'm looking at the Bible because 75% of this country are Christians. I'm sure I can look at the Quran. In fact, I know I can look at the Quran and mention your classism, your agephobia, your bigotry of any kind, which is, you know, Martin Luther King did that all the time. He pointed out the Bible and shit. The difference between him and I is I'm not a believer. I don't believe in God. But I can certainly look at the Bible and point out how you Christians are wrong. That doesn't cut the atheists free, because if I get the Christians to do right and then the atheists are still out there sinning and going against what they know to be common decency, like running their mouths, it is immature for you to talk shit about people that may have made one mistake and you exploit it like you're a fucking 2-year-old. You're not mature, is my point. And the Bible says that. So if you're a Christian, the Bible says your gossip mill is a sin about 100 times in 100 different verses. It says that your classism is a sin about 100 different times. And if you're an atheist, you're not mature if you're a shit talker. And most of y'all Gen Z adults support Bernie Sanders, so shut up, classes. Okay, so my point here after 11 minutes of tangenting, 10 minutes of tangenting, is I lost my spot. So I have to do this in the order because it's two verses in the Bible that I think is interesting. I'm an anti-theist and all, but I read the Bible because, you know, most of the country is Christian. I'll do it in the with the Quran if you really wanted me to. There's not a lot of Muslims around, you know. I largely won't date Muslims because they're anti-Semitic, and I largely won't date Jews because they're anti-Semitic towards Muslims. I think y'all are freaking morons. So I'm just saying, because most of the country is Christian, I'm going to point out your problem right here. The ageism, the age phobia. I've never been an ageist. I've dated older women that are like 20 years younger than me. Never. Because I've tried, they cut me off, kind of. I've tried to date women who are 20 years older, and it just, you know, good friendships, but it lasted better than dating women my own age. But, like, older women, I would recommend dating more than I would women my own age, certainly. Especially, like, 20 years older. They're more mature, you know. When I got cut off, it was my problem, and I will admit that that was my fault. But that was 8 years ago. Let that shit go. I bring it up because now you're bringing it up in public. And every time you do, I just want to say, shut your fucking mouth. And then you're like, why? So I got to be like, why not? So, you know, shut your fucking mouths. You could talk, just don't. What the Bible says is if you're running your mouth about people and lying and slandering them and deceiving and bringing up things and not being a forgiver when somebody may have done something that irritated your taboos, like me wanting to date women that are like 21. Or 18, your little bitch ass needs to shut up. So, where's it at? The Bible itself. I'm sorry, this is kind of the boring part of this show. It's in Proverbs. I had it marked, I lost my spot. And it's important. So, I mean, if you're an atheist and you got to call out Christians for their bullshit, just realize that you're both on the same page with your age phobia. Bigotry is wrong. You're a left winger. You ought to know better. But you Christians, I'm going to point out how you specifically are wrong to be age phobic. It's your problem, you little cock blocks, you little like, oh, you're 40, you're gross kind of thing, I'm never going to date you. You're little like run of the mouth. And not accepting that you have your narcissistic problems and your gaslighting. By not acknowledging the truth and saying that it's my problem. It's actually yours. So that's the secular argument against your bullshit. Here's the religious argument against your age phobia. I'm going to show you my hair. You can watch some of my other videos. This is important to what I'm saying. You see some gray hairs. You're 40. You got some gray hairs. In Spokane, there's guys that are 30 that have gray hairs. But I grew up on the West Coast and it's not as cold. So that has a large portion to do with it. I'm Generation X, and I see millennials with gray hair. I don't know. But what it says here in the Bible, and you could use this to possibly get laid, but don't forget that I exist and haven't gotten laid in 8 years, or had a girlfriend and I'm not married and don't have children, and I haven't had a lady in 8 years, so please be kind and remember who's giving you this information, graybeards. I don't hate you, but if you forgot me and you hook up with these chicks and you're not helping me out, you're not my brother. You're not my friend. You're a liberal and a leftist. You ought to know better. You're a Christian. You ought to know better. So from the secular and religious standpoint, Proverbs 16. Gray hair is a crown of splendor. It is attained in the way of righteousness. Proverbs 16:31. Then you turn over here to Psalm 33:5. The Lord loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of his unfailing love. So Christians, if you're agephobic, you're hypocrites. If you're atheists and you're agephobic, well, you're left-wing. I can't believe your bigotry. Oh, not going to date an anti-theist or an atheist. Well, then look at John 13:34-35. This says, love everybody. And again, I will remind you that you are supposed to be anti-bigot as a left-wing person. Christians, liberals, left-wingers. You know, you're on my side politically, but watch this Bible-thumping, secular-thumping, political, religious argument thing twice. It's 16:20. That ran a little long. But I think you get the point, hypocrites. It's your problem. Agephobia.